Good evening. Queensland is getting three brand new hospitals and expansions for 11 more in a historic multi-billion dollar spend to tackle our health crisis. Thousands of new beds will be brought online, headlining a state budget with the clear goal of ending ambulance ramping.
They said it'd be historic, the likes of which we've never seen. In anyone's language, it's big. A cash splash that underlines just how sick the health system is.
I'm now committing today to the biggest health investment that this state has ever seen.
This is a budget designed for the times we face. It's a budget that delivers for Queensland.
There's $23.6 billion for a system surviving on life support, choked by a ramping crisis with ambos unable to unload patients as they wait for beds. A $1.16 billion increase, or 5.6% jump in the operating budget, and a whopping $9.7 billion over 6 years to build new and bigger hospitals, delivering 2,200 new beds with another 280 brought forward.
A new era is dawning for Queensland. We are building the infrastructure for tomorrow. It is a budget that puts healthcare first.
There are new hospitals promised for Coomera with 404 beds, Toowoomba 118 beds, and another 121 at a new Bundaberg hospital.
This is the biggest investment that Queenslanders have ever seen.
Elsewhere in the southeast, expansions at Robina, Redcliffe, Ipswich, Logan, Brisbane's QE2, the PA and Prince Charles adding over 1,000 beds.
This is equivalent to the tripling size of the RBWH.
And around the state, extensions to Townsville, Cairns, Mackay and Hervey Bay, along with a previously announced standalone cancer hospital.
This is vital. I said that we would fix the issue.
The first of the new beds will come online within 2 years. The new hospitals are scheduled to be ready in the second half of 2027. There's $1.1 billion for the ambulance service, an increase of 11%, with the overall health funding increase to help meet the commitment to hire 9,475 frontline workers over the government's four-year term.
This is a record health budget.
Yeah.
Every year, the health budget grows. But this year, the increase is much more than just the usual.
Spending on mental health grows by $1.6 billion over 5 years, funded by a levy on businesses with a payroll of more than $10 million a year. Smaller companies get a payroll tax cut.
Those companies that will pay the mental health levy will be the top 1% of Queensland companies. And we think that's a fair thing for them to do.
After all the criticism, all the warnings, the government needs this plan to work.
For the last 7 years, the Palaszczuk government has destroyed the health system in Queensland, and now they're asking for another 7 years to fix it.
We needed that spending to be had yesterday. Over the next year, what we're seeing is just an increase, really, to cope with inflation, which is not enough.
Nine's state political editor Lane Calcutt joins me now. Lane, the $9 billion question is, will this fix the problem?
Well, Melissa, governments are often accused of band-aid fixes, but this is a massive amount of money to cure a health crisis and a major political headache. The problem is it'll take years to roll out, and the question then is, how do you ease ramping and overcrowding in the meantime?